Angry MGTOW here. And time is now up for women.
Yes. And today, we're going to talk about New Year's Eve. For years, I've had these issues with this lame, backwards-est holiday. And I wanted to talk about it, but back in the day, you know, the internet didn't exist. So, had to keep it to myself, you know? But now, I get to speak my mind, you know? Everything, all the time has to be on their terms, doesn't it? I mean, think about it. Think about how fucking ridiculous it is. In order to get a 5-second kiss, okay, you will need to buy the girl some flowers, to ask her out several times, her and the hundreds of other girls, get one to go out with you. You will need to pay several months in advance a substantial amount of money in order to reserve a place in a crowded, loud music having place. Somehow make sure that the girl doesn't during the party go with some Chad or Tyrone. Then you need to buy her several expensive drinks, from champagne to vodka to chasers and whatnot, because that's what it's traditional to do on New Year's Eve. And then you need to wait and suffer and keep the conversation going with foreign or lame backwards conversation topics all the way till midnight to get a kiss. And then you need to go to work the next day with a headache and an empty pocket, empty of money. Whereas nowadays, I can kiss a beautiful sex doll anytime that I want, without any excuses, without any backstory. Let me tell you what I'm going to do this New Year's Eve. I'm going to play a sim dating game called Aoi Tori. A-O-I-T-O-R-I. In my opinion, the best game ever up to date. I'm going to play it with my dolls watching me. Their blonde hair just flowing onto their backs. And I'm going to soak in a leg spa, which basically it's a tub with hot water and vibrations and air bubbles. And I'm also going to work out to lift some weights. I can lift 40 kilograms with one hand at the moment. I'm going to eat some delicious tuna fish. And while it's raining outside and it's nice and warm here in my man cave, and what else? I'm not playing by their terms. I mean, think about it. Justin Bieber, he doesn't play by their terms, does he? Those thousands of women, with 80% of the women just throw themselves at him, playing in his terms. But you know, the media in society will put pressure on you. So, who are you going out with tonight? Do you have someone? Are you going to some party? Are you a party guy? All that fucking shit. Luckily, I don't have the news anymore. I remembered we showed the newscasters kissing back in the day. And she was married. She was a married woman. But you know, it's the holiday and it's just a kiss. Fuck that. Disgusting. Some anti-MGTOWs. They like to criticize the dolls because they say you can't have kids with the dolls, you can't continue, blah blah blah. That's their mindset. They don't realize artificial intelligence is possible, and even if not, this is just bullshit. I see girls at work, and some of the days they don't have time, they don't have the patience, they come and they don't put on the sufficient amount of makeup, and you can see how truly disgusting they look. So for them to act like they have a a piece of shish kebab, and you're starving for food, and you're dependent on them to eat, it's plain and simple a bluff, you know? Think about the time, the freaking time people, men waste on this event. Not just, it's not just the money, it's the time. I mean, the courtship, the months ahead, the searches for the venue, all for a few seconds of feeling her lips after she, and she, more than, at most cases, it's like kissing an ashtray, because those can't smoke. They start smoking when Tyrone, or whatever fuck they fucked, gave them their fourth cigarette, and just won't stop ever since. Why should they? They have an endless supply of simps and manjanas to fund it. Sometimes, you know, you will see a girl work in some low income job, you know, a waitress, a retail cunt, That's not her only income, you know? She has income from her parents, she has income from simps, she has the beta orbiters funding her if she needs to eat something, they will buy it for her. If she needs something clean, they will clean for her. All for the promise of some pussy, you know? And then we'll find out, oh, she's fucking some Tyrone, oh. And she simply replaces them. She replaces the simps, you know, she goes on an app. That's why simps don't have money, you know? They don't. A simp can work at as a doctor and still he will be broke, you know? And a MGTOW can work as a retailer and he'll be loaded with money. Because he's not supporting, you know, the cunt. He's not supporting the New Year's Eve industry. He's not supporting the nightclub. He's not supporting the alcohol beverage companies, okay? He's not supporting the tobacco companies. He's not supporting the wedding industry. He's not supporting the clothes industry. He's not supporting the jewelry industry. What does a MGTOW buy, you know? Maybe a bicycle, maybe a cheap ride, a reliable automobile that gets him from A to B, a computer, some comfortable furniture maybe, some healthy food that is healthy, none of it soy shit. You know? You know, at workplaces, you know, they'll offer you alcoholic beverages, they will offer you the snacks, they will offer you the cakes. Don't eat it. For two reasons. One, it contains soy. It changes you into a mangina. Believe it or not. You know, I worked at retail, okay? And when I saw, I took a good look at the people that buy the soy. And they always had boobs. The men that buy those soy products, soybeans, and then the soy with the pads, and the tofu, you know? They always had moobs. Boobs, men boobs. Always. Always. A very low amount of muscle mass. Always. And the second reason, you take one bite out of that cake, you take one sip out of a drink, and believe it or not, they can sue you, they can say you are a thief. They will fire you, you will not get your settlement. That's how it works. Why the fuck do they think I will come on to a goal from work? Why? I can't be myself before. That's first of all, okay? I can't be like, let's say I want to ask her out, okay? Hypothetically, okay? I think she's hot, okay? I'm a man, I have a penis, you know, I want to fuck, okay? I can't tell her, you know, like, hey, what's your number? Give me your number, let's go out. No. Because, I have to live with her, you know, I have to suffer her at work. And even if she does says yes or no or whatever she says, I can't react as myself, you know, I can't say, well, fuck you, bitch! I'm gonna order a fucking prostitute, you know? Cause it's work, and there are cameras, and she can tell lies to her friends. Let me read to you a list of an example list of stuff you can learn with the time that you would waste on those fucking cunts on New Year's Eve and whatever the fuck it is. Animation course with 3D printing. Here's the syllabus, Autodesk Maya, advanced character modeling, concept art, Adobe Photoshop, ZBrush, 3D printing, advanced 3D animations, Unity game making, editing and compositing, simulations with 3ds Max and V-Ray. You can make the singer Hatsune Miku dance for you and talk with you. Okay? You can make money. You can become self-sufficient, quit your job. You know? Think about it. And then they try to shame and make people feel bad about not getting a New Year's Eve kiss, and they do that fucking countdown and they show all the people kissing. That's sick, you know, I don't want to see them kiss. To me, any cat that I see kissing, you know, fuck her to hell. She can go to hell. Why the fuck does she need to do it in front of my face? Why does everybody need to see her do it? I don't post myself, you know, fucking my dolls, kissing my dolls, whatever. I don't do it. Like, they're trying to start a fight. That's what women thrive on, chaos. They do. You can't silence the truth, you know. I don't need to, you know, order a prostitute and post on the internet, hey, look at me. Did you see me kiss her? I'm the man. Did I pass the pre-selection and now I can get my more girls? Yes. Did I pass your pre-selection? Is the girl good enough to pass your pre-selection? Yeah, do I need to undergo the interview from your the ugly bull-dyke friend? Huh? Where do I live? How much money do I make? Do I have a girlfriend that passes the pre-selection? What are they being like spiteful? What are they trying to show? Like, hey, look how disgusting the guy I'm kissing is. Maybe you have a chance with me. You see, I'm not a lesbian. All sorts of distorted logics, okay? In my workplace, there are so many. Where I worked, okay? I see so many of those single moms describing how their, this one bitch, you know, she says she escaped from Russia 15 years ago with her two children from her fag husband. And I'm like, how did she get a car? With her salary and two backwards children that she has. And 15 years she still hasn't mastered the language. She only like 5% proficient, even less than that. These cunts can't tell us to conform to their schedule, to their prices, okay? And why is that? It's because we have the brains. We have brains that, what's it called? Adapt. And right now the adaption is artificial intelligence. And it's not just me, okay? It can be also you. It is the all sorts of companies. You see CGI. You see Hatsune Miku, the Vocaloid. You see Gatebox. You see the, what's his name? Late Rang with his Project Aiko. You see Geminoid. You see Abyss Creations. You see San Hui sex dolls. All over. Because nature finds a way. They decided to go against nature. Money isn't nature. Money is just paper. Let's pause this.
For men, like, share, subscribe, and if you like the product, respond to themselves. Let me know if you guys agree that this is the end for women and a new beginning for men. Like, share, subscribe, and if you like the video, share the video. And just remember that all rules lead to MGTOW or death. And cheers.
Like, share, comment, subscribe. Now me. Like, share, comment, subscribe, share. And remember, all rules lead to MGTOW or death. And cheers. Let me know in the comments whose ending is better, mine or Angry's. That's the button.